Hey, this is Jordan, bringing you a fifth update now on my Pheidole colony. This new naturalistic setup has been growing quite well. I've made a few changes since the last video. I've since added in some red sand here, which I really think contrasts the plants well and the rocks well. And it gives the terrarium that sort of desert, outback sort of theme I was going for. The sand is actually from Central Australia, so that sort of adds to that realism. The plants have been growing quite well too. Won't be long before they're poking up the top of the glass, so I may have to trim them back a bit soon. You can see this one's flowered, which is pretty neat. The ants have been doing great too. You may have noticed I've removed the brick nest that was in their last video, so the ants have entirely moved underground now. At first they would only really place brood in chambers up against the glass during the night and then move them out of sight during the day, but they don't seem to be as bothered about exposing their brood to light anymore. Perhaps they've built up a tolerance to the light, or maybe they've just discovered that the light doesn't pose any real threat to them like it might in the wild, so they're sort of abandoning their natural instincts a bit. The chambers are usually quite small and scattered around. This is the largest chamber here, that's visible to me at least. So you can see there's heaps of pupae and larvae here. They tend to favour this spot in the middle as the soil often remains quite dry. There's a good deal of soldier pupae here as well, so that's a good sign that the colony is doing well. Here's another underground section, which sees lots of ant traffic. They really didn't like me shining this light at them here. You can see they look as though they're getting a little agitated. They've been constructing like heaps of nest entrances lately. Dozens of little ant hills are popping up, pretty much spanning the entire surface area of the setup, so they're really making use of this whole space. I find they usually build their entrances like amongst the roots and the stems of the plants. But it changes all the time, like they constantly build entrances and then abandon them for new ones. And I notice when I place a bit of food, which is a little too heavy for the ants to carry, instead of trying to haul that back to the nearest nest entrance, they may just start making a new nest entrance like right where the food source is. And they'll just dig up from underneath it, and the food source slowly becomes submerged. This setup has been attracting some other animals too, namely these little flies here. I feed this colony apple quite frequently, so they really love just sitting on these little slices and eating away. So they've been living in here and repopulating, and subsequently the flies started to attract some spiders. So there's a few in here at the moment, only very small ones, but yeah, they've been feeding pretty well, noticing lots of flies in their webs and catching lots of these little things. Occasionally I see them catching some of the ants as well, but I only really see one or two every now and then, so I'm not too worried. So I've got a bit of a mini ecosystem going here, which is pretty cool. I've been experimenting a bit with the colony's diet recently. I discovered they really love nuts. I've been giving them peanuts and almonds and cashews as well. They especially love cashews. So that's been a major part of their diet the past couple of months. And they look to be benefiting from it. The workers are looking a really healthy size. It's probably the biggest I've ever seen them, so the larvae must be getting well nourished as they're developing really well. They love their honey. I've been putting little drops around the setup. Notice there's actually a soldier here who's actually drinking the honey. I've never actually seen a soldier consuming the honey directly from the source like this. Usually the workers will feed them via trophallaxis, so this was a little unusual to see. So that's all for this update. I'll probably do another one down the track, maybe in a couple of months. I wanted to ask you guys and girls, if there's any that watch these videos, what do you want to see more of on this channel? A lot of people request me to do more colony updates. Some people want to see more footage of wild ants. I've been thinking of doing some tutorial style videos that would cover some sort of frequently asked questions that I get, like how to find and catch queen ants, or how to successfully raise up a newly caught queen. So leave a comment and let me know what sort of future videos you'd like to see from me. As always, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed.